for modern flower creation. So today I will be showing you how to make my Jane Austen paper flower. And this is my template. I will be making a medium size flower, so you will only need the first three sizes, which are these right here. I have already cut them. They are right here. So you will need six of these. Now you can make more if you like, so you can make 8 pieces of these, 8 of these, and 8 of these, or you can even do 5. I choose to do 6 for today. And I will also be using my medium base. So I'll be tracing this on a piece of paper, same color as this one, to get the base for the flower. So we will get started. I am using 67 cardstock paper by Nina. So you will need scissors, a hot glue gun with glue stick. You'll also need a wooden dowel to curl. And you will also need cardstock paper, 65, 67, whatever thickness you want to use for your flower, you decide. So now that I've already cut the 3 sizes, I will be curling them. First with the little one. Curling like that. And then the other side, I'm gonna curl it up. So at the end, you want to help it with your hands. You want to roll it up a little, like that, and you'll get this result. And then what you want to do is you want to cut with your scissors. If you cut more than halfway, then your flower is going to be flat. But if you cut a little less than halfway, then your flower will be more upward. So I am cutting a little less than halfway. Cutting that much. And we will do the same thing for the other petals. So again, this side right here, I'm gonna grab the dowel, put it right there like that, and curling it. Now I am curling all 6 petals at the same time. However, you don't have to do this. You can curl 2 at a time or even 1 at a time. It's really up to you. It's based on your preference. And again, once I curl it with a dowel, I'm just gonna give it a little help with my hands and curling it. And you can continue using your dowel for this. And again, you'll have this. Thank you. Again, just helping the petal with my hands. We are cutting again. Again, I'm not cutting it all the way. This one, I think I cut it in more compared to the other petals, but that's okay because it'll be covered by the other petals. So now that we have all of our sizes, again, this is for a medium flower, and we have, I'm using three different size petals. They're all done. I am going to be cutting the base. And you can do your own base. This is, you can use this freehand, free draw it. Space through Cricut. Grab our glue gun. We will put the base to the side because we don't need it yet, and we will start gluing the petals. So we will be putting glue right here, right here, and bringing this right here up and folding it like this. So it'll end up looking like this. So you want to do the same thing for the other ones. We're going to move on to the next size. You don't have to use a lot of glue. Last size. Now that we have all of our petals glued, we will start adding them to the base. So we will start with the largest petals, and we will add glue right here. So this side is inward. will add to the back side where the little pointy thing is. So right here. So you just wanna add that much. Maybe a little bit more. And then we are gonna add it to one side. Adding the petals to each side. Of the largest size. And there you go. You have one layer down. We're going to continue with the second to largest petal size. And for this one, we will add the glue, so this is the back side of the petal. We will add the glue right here on the left side, only on the left side. Like that. And we're just gonna, there's like the circle. We're gonna add it in the middle of these two petals. That's where we're gonna add it. And for the next petal, same size, you're just gonna wanna do the same thing that you did with the first size petal. Glue, not glue just on the left side, but the entire thing. Two more petals of this size. For the last one, I will show you why I did the left side only on the first one. So this is the last one. Glue on that. And now we are gonna do this. So the left side, or the right side of that petal, you can kind of open it up because we will put this under like that, making sure that it's still in the middle of these two petals right there. And then just adding glue right down there, so you close it off. Just adds a spiral effect. And now the last size petal, or last layer, we're going to do the same thing. We are going to add glue on the left side, only a little bit, like that. And the same thing, we're going to put it in between these two, the most recent layer. Blood was inspired by a fabric that I have in my office at work that I got from Joann's, and I'm always staring at it, and there are so many pretty flowers on that fabric, and a petal stood out to me, and this was the design of the petal, so I was able to, or that petal was able to inspire me to create this template. Center. And the center will be this right here. This is it's from Cricut Design Space. One of the images, I believe it's one of the cartridges called 3D Floral, and you're able to find this image right here. I used my Cricut Maker to cut the design, and then you're just gonna put the dandelion image right there. So you're gonna glue the back side right there, just a little bit, and you are going to put it right there. You can put other centers on it if you like. It is based on preference. I do have another center that I created, and I can put that one there as well. So the flower ends like that. Thank you for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe to Modern Flower Creation.